Rahman Rahim. Today we are going to teach you about the circuit breaker failure. So this is the ZIV relay. This is the ZIV relay about which we will perform the testing. So you can see this for our current and earth fault protection F1. Now before making video, we will give you about the details of this video. What is circuit breaker failure? Okay, so this video will contain the following features. What is circuit breaker failure? When circuit breaker failure will be activated? So CBF initiate activation and then setting from the ZIV relay. So here we are going to test this function by ZIV relay. So all information will be about ZIV relay will be included here, and then the configuration. And number fifth, we will going to inject and measure the time. How we will measure the time? So that's how our procedure will go. So right now we will start about what is CBF. Actually, for example, we have, for example, we have a setting. Okay, for example, we have a setting value for our current 0.3 ampere. Now, for example, if current is 0.3 or above 0.3 value, according to our set value, it should trip the breaker, right? So here I will show you, we have one our current relay, which we named this by R1, right? This have a set value, for example, 0.3 ampere. Here we have one CT. So for example, this relay setting value for example 0.3 ampere. So this is one relay. For example, we give it the name of R1, which is used for our current function. So when the current reach 0.3 or above 0.3, this relay will be picked. So this relay, when this relay picked, so there will be one timer here. This, for example, 15 milliseconds. So after 15 milliseconds, this context will be picked and will give circuit breaker to trip coil to trip the breaker, right? Okay. Now at the same time, first this portion, for example, this portion fails. I mean, trip not happened here. What will we do next? So here we introduced you to the concept of breaker failure. Now breaker is failed already. So what will we do the next? So next is this procedure, which will give you the whole information about the circuit breaker failure. What is circuit breaker failure, and how circuit breaker failure will be initiated, and what it will do. Okay. So we have another relay which is named by R2. So for example, if this R1 picked and the breaker still not opened, so it means a breaker failure. So here we introduce you to the second relay, which is given a name by R2. So R2 is used for circuit breaker failure. Okay, so at the same time, as I told you, this contact will be picked, and when this contact picked, this timer will start. This timer, for example, T1 is 150 milliseconds. So when this 150 milliseconds reached, so it will give again chance to the same breaker to retrip again. This is called retrip. This is called retrip chance. And at the same time, we have another timer in this R2 relay, which is fit. For example, it depends on setting, but I here as an example give it 180 milliseconds. So means after this time reached, this will start, and after 30 milliseconds, this will give command to trip all breakers related to fault side, right? Anything related to fault, it will give trip command, including bus section. This may be bus section, incomers, outgoing feeders, anything related to this, maybe in the same stream, maybe upstream. So this is the whole concept about the circuit breaker failure. Now a few parameters which we want to explain in the same concept, and then we will show you from the setting and measure the time, right? As I told you, when this relay picked, so this T equal to 15 milliseconds, after this contact will be picked. At the same time, this contact will also be picked.
okay, then this timer will start. When this timer start, it will give the retrip chance again to the same circuit breaker to trip again. Okay, now here the few things which we need to involve in the parallel. We put one another contact for SF6 low. This is the SF6 low. Same, we take one contact from FS6 low, spring charged and trip coil faulty, like this. These are in parallel with this. Okay, so this contact for
spring not charged.
CBF, right? This one for FS6 low. So any of the contact picked, it will start the timer and it will trip this, and after it is not retripped, so it will give trip command for this one, right? Another concept we have, instead of using T1 and T2 concept here, which I explained to you, it will give another chance. This T1 will give another chance to the same breaker to trip again. But here also we have some schemes which don't give a chance again to this, because here also V1 fault. So why we need to give another chance to the same breaker to trip again? So we will keep one timer. We will keep one timer and we will use this timer. So after this time reached, it will trip all the related faulty side breakers. Anything, any breakers related to this fault, it will make trip for that. So this is the whole concept about the circuit breaker failure. Now the next portion, we will go for setting and configuration. So for setting, we will set it like this. Now, for example, this is a neutral time over current. I select unit 1 and then come to the neutral time over current. This is my set value for over current pickup, right? Okay. Now, next, we will go for breaker failure. In the protection, there one option, breaker failure. This breaker failure, open this one. Okay, now here breaker failure, phase pickup and breaker failure ground pickup. So we will make this, for example, 0.3. It should be noted that this value should be less than the over current pickup. This value should be less than the over current pickup. This is important to note. Now I send this setting to the relay. Another thing is the breaker failure delay. These are the time delay. This is T2 and this is T1. T1 is the retrip delay. For example, here 0.3, okay, and this one maximum we kept up to 2 seconds. So this just to give you the information. So that's why we kept it to measure the value and measure it from Frisia. So that's why we kept this high. This is the maximum limit. You cannot select more than 2 seconds delay, right? This usually less than 2. Now we will send this to the relay. Okay, it's already sent to the relay. Configuration, how we configured this, these outputs. So here is the output number 32, which we used for the retrip. These two wires, red wires, this from output 32, which are being configured for a retrip. Here you can see this output number 32 configured for a retrip. Okay. Then the next one, input output logic, outputs. And then in outputs, come to the output number 31. Output number 31. Here,
is output number 31. This is configured for breaker failure activation. So this was the whole concept about the circuit breaker failure, circuit breaker failure concept, and circuit breaker failure activation settings, configuration, and measurements and injection. Now we will inject. So before injection, I will give you some information about the connection diagram. Right, this is the red, yellow, and blue phase for current, which is going to the 22, 24, 26, and 28, which I can show you here in the drawing. 22 red phase, 24 yellow phase, and 26 blue phase, and 28 neutral. So this is going to the relay, ZIV relay. This, these are the three coils which are going to pick the over current and earth fault. Right. After this, these four are the related. Now we will use one multimeter for connectivity to show us that over current is picked. So over current pick up these two wires we take from the over current output. The over current output initiated here is 2 and 4. Here this is the contacts of the ZIV relay, TS1 number 2 and 4. So these wire we take from 2 and 4 of TS1, which belongs to F1, E5 and E6. This is the ZIV output for over current and earth fault protection. Right. Now the next, the output which is configured for breaker failure activation, which we will show you from the configuration, okay? So this will stop the timer from the free jump. So this is the whole concept which we will use now. Now I will not use these two, and I will show you that time over current, that this over current is enabled now. And by continuity, we will know that now there is over current. So over current, it will give trip to the... Now here, as I show you in the setting, my value for over current pickup is 0.5, right? So 0.5, now this value is more than 0.5. When I inject, now you can hear this sound from the multimeter that this contact is picked. Okay, so these two contacts, these two wires belongs to the circuit breaker failure activation. Okay, and now we have another two wires which from our ZIV relay go to output number 31. Okay, these two wires for retrip. These two wires for retrip. Okay, so now I will start injection. Here you can hear the multimeter sound that relay F1 over current output is picked. Okay, now I will stop this and connect the freezer, connect the output of retrip delay. Right, this is the retrip. So when I inject here, here you can see from the setting, this is the retrip which I explained you, this is the T1. Okay, so this, the set value is 0.3, and here the measured value is 366 milliseconds. So after this, we will remove these contacts and fix the contacts of the breaker failure activation. So now we remove the breaker, the retrip contacts, and fix the breaker failure activation. Now we will inject again. At the same time, you can hear the sound, and after 2.06 seconds, this contact is picked. This contact is picked after 2.06 seconds. Now go to the settings. here you can see this value, breaker failure delay. Breaker failure delay. The value is set to be 2 seconds. So after 2.06 seconds, this value is picked. So after this time, it will give command. It will initiate command to trip the incomer bus section or anything related to the fault. So it will make trip for those all circuit breakers. So this was the whole concept about the circuit breaker failure. Hope that you will understand this clearly.